Today, I'm going to show you how to use Tinkercad to make an endless bubble wrap popping fidget. So let's get cracking. So if this is your first time visiting Tinkercad, this is the homepage. Of course, you can get there by visiting Tinkercad.com. This is what your homepage looks like. I always choose sign in with Google. Today, we're going to start by just hitting create new 3D design. I like to start out by changing the name. I'm going to call this Bubble Wrap Popper. Once you click down here, it is saved. I'll show you real quick. We can bounce back to the Tinkercad dashboard. There is your project. You can see here is where I started it. If you want to go back into your private project, you can simply hit Tinker This. Now in Tinkercad, you can right-click, drag to change your angle. These are the basic shapes you can play with. We're going to start with a cube. I've got some special numbers for you. I'm going to tell you to type 3 right here for the radius, and check it out. That is a cool rounded shape in one click. It has 10 steps of rounding. If you change this to 1, it chisels the edges. We really want to keep it 10, so I'm going to put it back like that. Now, I do want to show you this. If I bring out another one, I put that same number 3, which turned out pretty cool. If you grab these handles and stretch them, it breaks that rounding, and it also breaks the numbers. If we check this one out, see how it's 20 by 20? We want to make it 34 by 34. If I type 34, the rounding stays. If I type 34, the rounding stays. And we also want to make the height 12. This is the shape we want to build with. If we take this one and move it down to 34, which we can also type, and then I'm going to check this angle and make it 34 as well. And of course, we need to make that height 12. They get similar, but the rounding on this one is much better. And if you ever click this shape again, see how it's 34? The parameters are broken. Once you drag handles, you break the cool parameters that we're going to use. So make sure you store that away. That is something that a lot of tinkerers ask questions about. So this is the mechanism we are going to use to make a popper. This is called a hole. We're going to cut 4 of these into here. And once it's cut, this will all be gone, but there will be a little piece right here that clicks when this piece touches it. So we've got a solid that's going to be the peg, and we've got the hole that's going to get cut out. Let's build the peg first. The purple shape down on the bottom is a cone. Simply bring out your cone, and let's change some parameters. We want a top radius of 5. We want a bottom radius of 4.9. Once you press enter, we're going to set the height at 0.2 and the sides stay at 48. This gives us a shape that's a little bit rounded, which is nice when you're pressing down on it from either side of the project. Next up, we're going to add the orange cylinder. When I bring it out, I'm going to cruise it right on top, not on the work plane, on top of the purple shape. Then we can simply hold down shift. This is essential because we're stretching it all the same amount, and we want to go to size 10. Notice I let go, click, type 10, and press enter. Now the height of that obviously needs to change. The correct number that we need, we can simply click the box and type 3.6 in the box. Next up, we're going to cruise out another purple cone. Once again, cruise it on top. And then your numbers on this one are 3.5. Press enter. 5. Press enter. And then we want a height for this of 1.2. And we're going to stick with the 48. We will align these when we're all done. We can just keep building right now. Cruise another cylinder on top. Once again, we are going to shift squeeze. This time we're going to type the number 7 and press enter. Then we can click on it. We can adjust the height. The number we want for the height is 1.2 and press enter. Let's return to the cone. Of course, cruise it on top. This time you're going to type the number 4 and press enter. 3.5 for the base and press enter. And the height here is 0.6 and press enter. Once again, keeping the sides. Now we can go back to the cylinder, bring it out. Once again, shift squeeze. Let's go from this corner. We're going to type the number 8 and press enter. And then let's adjust the height to 0.6 by simply typing the number in the box. of course, now we need to build the other half. Check this out. We're going to move that to the side so we can simply grab the entire bottom section, do Control D, press W for the work plane, set the work plane on top, and do D to drop. Finally, hit the mirror tool to flip it. Now I'm going to put the work plane back on the bottom, pressing W for work plane, grabbing everything we built. Let's choose the letter L, click on one of the bottom pieces, and choose center and center. I'm going to quickly select that and do Control G to group. We'll delete this one so now it's not in our way. So this hole shape needs to be larger than our real shape. We're going to add 0.2 of clearance on each side. So let's start with bringing out a cylinder. Once again, do the shift squeeze. And then instead of 10, we're going to type 10.4. That gives us 0.2 on every side. And then we're going to adjust the height down to size 4. Next up, we bring out a cone. Once again, cruise it right on top of that shape. And the parameters you want to type are 4.1, 5.2. If you're checking the math, don't forget 5.2 equals 10.4 when you're doing the diameter. And then we're going to simply do a height of 1, and we're going to keep the 48 sides. Now we're going to cruise out another cylinder, put it right on top. Once again, we're going to shift squeeze. This time we're going to type the number 8.2 and press enter. We do want to set the height of that part to 2. We are going to reuse this cone right here. So do Control D, hit C for cruise, grab that dot, and set the new one up on top. Now notice it's the wrong way, so all we do is hit M for mirror and bingo, flip it. Of course, you can also use the mirror toolbar button. Let's do the same thing to bring this part up. Once again, Control D to duplicate, C for cruise, grab the dot, and set it on top. Let's select them all, choose L for align, and choose center and center. Now the final thing we have to do is make this one taller. We're simply going to change that number to 7 and press enter. Now we need to build the mechanism that makes this work. When this cuts out, it leaves a little strip right here that this part bumps into, and that's how we get the clicking sound. We're going to start by building this little cutout, and we're going to do that with the sketch tool. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see the grid better. I've got my grid set to 1, and we're going to simply drop this on a 20 by 20 grid. Notice that dotted line lines up right with the grid marker. Now, of course, this is the sketch tool. If you've never seen it before, there is an awesome tutorial that explains it. There are 5 different windows that you can check out. Tons of great information, lots of cool animations. Of course, when you're done learning these, you can hit continue sketch. If you'd rather check out my tutorials, I'll put a link up here to the full playlist. Now, the part we're going to build is pretty small, so switch to the 0.1 measurements. Start from this center grid mark right here, and I want you to stretch it to the right, and we want to go 1.8 millimeters. That's how tiny this is. Now zoom in on it, and we're going to go up 1.1. Now we're going to go up 0.3, and we're going to go over until it says 0.42. That's the exact number you need. This way we're going to go to 1.2, click, and then we're going to do that same 0.3 over and go down until it says 0.42. And then when you click right here, you can double click and check your measurements. 1.1, 1.1, 1.8, 1.2. And of course, these two are both 0.42. This is the shape that's going to bump to make that clicker. Now you could adjust this and come up with different ones, but this is what we're going to start with for our scratch project. Now that we've got it built, let's get it oriented. I'm going to bring it over here, and we're going to rotate it 90 degrees. Notice when you rotate, if you stay inside that little circle, it's easy to go 22.5 degrees at a time. If you hold down shift, it goes 45 degrees at a time. We want it with this little piece facing in. And then we also want to look at it from a corner. Notice I'm just using the view cube. We can hit that, and then this is the rotation handle. And once again, the rotation widget lets us rotate it 90 degrees, 22.5 at a time, or if you hold shift, it's 45 degrees at a time. I'm going to move this close to our shape we're building. We now need to bring out a cube. We're going to use that shift shrink again, and the number we need this time is 2.1 and press enter. Notice this is going to wrap around that shape. We do need to change it with the black handles in this direction to make it size 10 and press enter. We also need to change the height of this to 2.6 and press enter. All right, friends, this is the important step, getting everything aligned. We're going to hit L for align on this, and we're going to click front and center and middle. Now we're going to click on that one, make sure we've got the 0.1 nudge. We're going to nudge it back 1-2 clicks. For a minute, we're going to turn this into a hole, and we're going to take those two and do Control G to group. Now I do want to highlight, we have to undo that in a minute, so don't forget to switch that. Now we need to place them precisely in this, and we're going to do that with a cube. Bring out the cube, do shift squeeze, and then the number we've got to have is 7.2, and press enter. We can now take these shapes and do L for align. You can see here this wasn't lined up anyhow. And when we do L for align, we want center, and we want center. Now this part is going to line up right with this edge. Let's do W for work plane, do D to drop, and then shift select that center, and we want to do L for align with it being the boss. So notice I'm clicking that center piece, and if we look at the view cube here, you can see this is the center that way, and then also we want the center vertically. So now that one is perfectly placed for where we need it. We just need to also put it on this side. So I'm going to put the work plane right here, W for work plane, Control D, D for drop. And then we need to take that shape and flip it with the mirror tool. Bang. I'm going to put the work plane back down on the ground. We can now click on our 7.2 cube and hit delete. And we need to ungroup both of these. Now we can select those pieces and do Control G to group. Hit the letter H to make it a hole. And friends, right there is the magic piece. This is cut out, and that way when this slides through, it's going to hit that little spot right there and make the clicking sound. That's the mechanism that makes it all come together. Let's select the two items right now and do L for align. We do need to make sure they stay in the exact alignment. We need four of these. I'm making a four popper, so here's how we're going to set it up. Switch to a 5mm nudge. We're going to do the holes first. Control D. And do 1, 2, 3 to put a gap between them. Now we can shift select the two of them. And once again, Control D, 1, 2, 3. And you've got your gaps set up. I'm going to shift select those four. Double check that we've got the four. And do Control G so they stay together. I can hide those for a moment. And I'm going to do the same thing here. Once again, Control D. And then we're going to go 1, 2, 3. With our 5mm nudge, and I can grab those two and do Control D, and 1, 2, 3 with our 5mm nudge. With those aligned, I'm also gonna do Control G to group. That way it stays aligned. Let's do show all to bring everything back. We're gonna check the alignment by switching to flat view. Make sure we're viewing it from the top. I'm gonna hit F to fit view. And if you check the amount on every side, the gap is the same, so that means it's all lined up. I'm going to go back to perspective view. We can look at it from the home view. Let's grab these parts, shift select this part, and choose L for align. I'm going to make this one the boss and choose center and center. Final step is to select the holes and select our red shape. Notice it says two shapes selected, and do Control G to group. Bang. We have just made an endless bubble wrap fidget. I'm going to get this sent to the 3D printer. Today we're going to print it with the Bamboo Labs P1S. Of course, I could do multiple colors, but we're going to send it as a single color for this project just because it's so much faster. I'm going to save it in my 3D modeling folder. I'm going to add the word final after it and hit save. There have been a few versions as I was getting this tested. course, now we can bounce to Bamboo Studio. I'm going to choose Create New Project. Let's add that file. There is the bubble wrap popper. I'm going to stick with this yellow, 0.2 standard settings. Let's slice the plate. I'll also real quickly slide down so we can see how this is happening. And then right there, you can see that bar that is going to make the clicking sound. How cool is that? Looks like it's going to take about 30 minutes to print. Let's hit print plate, double check our colors, and send it to the 3D printer. And about 30 minutes later, bubble wrap fidget. How cool is that? As I wrap up, I want to say thanks to Sharon real quick. She posted this in my Patreon messaging area, and it was a pretty fun project to solve. Of course, I also want to thank everybody that supported me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via Patreon. That group is getting bigger and bigger every day. The messaging area is absolutely fantastic. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.